Thank you for the clip. And more, I find new reasons to hate gaming news and game journalism. Just saw a tweet from some website called Gaming Bolt in my feed, where they're like, Starfield's player numbers continue to plummet. The game could be in trouble. And it's like, it's a single player game. It's not a live service game. Shut the fuck up. There's no issue if player numbers drop for a single player game. Listen, I'm there for the dank memes and pet photos, Gino. Like, Paperback Paradise. It's one of my favorite Twitter accounts.
I hope the others are safe.
The Enterprise was clear of the gap when we fell. They made it, Joe. And they will have seen the ice where it led. We need only wait till dawn.
Are we gonna watch him bang?
Maybe there really is nothing else for it but to give yourself to his master. Only you won't do that. The Clive I know would never do that.
So you believe? But do you really know me? If what Barnabas said was true, then monster than man. And each time I summon the flames from within, I burn away the things that make me who I am.
Do you, though? Think of what you've used that power for, of all the people you've saved. It doesn't matter how or by whom it was granted, only how you choose to use it. And you've chosen to use it for good, haven't you?
I've also used it to kill. What if that's my purpose? What if it's all I'm good for?
You're still that same boy I grew up with. Always so eager to save everyone around you, and yet always so alone. Because you failed to realize the one thing that needed saving most of all. You, Clive. You. You never once took the time to save yourself.
Well, good night, Tori.
Myself. I think I might be beyond saving.
No one is beyond saving. Provided they want to be saved. You fight to survive. And you survive so that you may protect those you love. It's what you do. What you've always done. And I know you're not about to change. So I'm going to help you. To give you what you need to protect us all.
Jill. Are you sure? this is what you want, then...
Don't worry, Clive. It is. This burden... I'll give you the strength to bear it alone.
But I'm not alone.
He's giving her the suck.
If I am to continue on, having pledged my life to those I love, then I will gladly bear your burdens too, until my last breath. We might one day look upon the moon again, together.
And I promise you, Clive, that I will be there, no matter what you must become.
I thought a smile could bring me so much joy.
Oracle's tired from watching him bang all night.
What of Barnabas?
No, it was a great scene, yeah.
Do we pursue him?
No. Our paths will cross again soon enough. Whether we like it or not. Besides, there is something we must do first.
Let's eat each other's asses. It's his tradition.
Of course. Drake's spine. The last mother crystal.
The Einherja is at the bottom of the sea. Walud won't dare move on Storm without her. But they know we're coming now.
It's like Bubba Hotep.
We need a plan. And a damn good one at that.
You extract the soul from the asshole.
Then let's go home and find one. Ash will have to wait.
Excuse me.
Mid says Odin split the sea in two. She's always been partial to a tall tale. But there's tall, and then there's tall.
I struggle to believe it myself.
I see your uncle isn't with you.
He stayed with the Enterprise. After our brush with the Einherja, she was in urgent need of repair. And my uncle knows a shipwright in Randalar. We're to join him there when we're ready to sail for Ash.
You sure that's wise? Last I heard, the place was still overrun with a Kashyyyk.
Show me a city where that isn't true. Ultima's plague is spreading.
We're running out of time, aren't we? We've done our best to shore up the hideaway. But I doubt a few planks will stop what's coming. Still, we'll keep at it. Every little helps, I suppose.
Let's hope so.
Yay.
I should visit Joshua. Assuming Talia will allow it.
No!
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Come to claim your just desserts. You earned this. All done?
Heard the bad news then, did you?
What bad news?
About Dravosht. Blackthorn's old haunt. With the forge and all that. Well, anyway, the mines just down the road from there are spewing at ether like no one's business.
And the village?
Safe from the flood for now, but they've got other problems. A Kashyyyk. Every creature in the area is either turned, or on the way to turning, apparently. Zoltan and the others are living on borrowed time. They need help, and quick. Doris sent a few curse breakers to keep an eye on things, but there's only so much a couple of scouts can do. Except get eaten. If something ain't done soon, the old place will be overrun.
I won't let that happen.
Didn't think you would.
Does Blackthorn know?
I thought it might be better if he didn't. He'd only do something stupid. You reckon we should tell him?
No. It's better this way.
Yeah, well, I can't stand about knowing what's happening out there, so I'm off. I'll see you in Dravosht.
Oh boy, more sad blacksmith time. What do you do?
Clive. Anything catch your eye?
The saddest, drunkest blacksmith.
Oh, it just warps me to the... Okay, yeah, sure. I mean, I gotta go back to the hideaway. Because there's more quests there. Chicken chaser! Actually. Holy shit! We got fucking side quests for days now, all of a sudden. Yeah. Side quests for days. Wait a minute.
Is that the potion one?
It's in mid's dungeon.
How was she? The Enterprise, I mean.
Ah, Sid. Just the man I was hoping to see. Did you have a mo?
Don't tell me. You need more bomb ash.
Oh, no. We still got plenty of that left. I'm working on bringing another one of Lachief's designs to life. This time, it's a new smelter. It's got a reverberatory hood over the top for additional thermo amplification.
Ooh.
A system of recirculatory regenerators that. Let's just say it gets very blimmin' hot. A heck of a lot hotter than anything Blackthorn's got in his forge, that's for certain. Only mithril engines get hotter. You can't chuck ore in one of them and get metal out the other end. Trouble is, we won't be able to make out of any old rubbish neither.
Yeah, okay, so I'm only going to be doing two side quests. I'm going to put the rest on the back burner.
Get her hands on exactly that. Any chance you could help
for right now.
If it's for the good of the hideaway, I'd be happy to.
This one gives me potions, and the blacksmith one gives me access to the strongest weapon of the game.
What exactly is this good stuff you need me to find?
Don't worry about the other side quests later. I want to get to this cinematic that Lee keeps talking about. Here.
Spherical echoes, we call them.
More fallen materials. So this smelter is similar to the mithril engine in more ways than one.
That's right. They're a bit like the thermal helms. Fallen ceramics deal with heat like nothing else, see? And what's more, they're directional, transferring heat from the inside to the outside. But these things, they're all outside. If we line the hub with them, they'll reflect the heat right back into the furnace. We've collected as many as we can, and I know where we can get the rest. Trouble is, they're all watched over by their bigger, uglier cousins.
So you want me to visit some ruins, destroy some echoes, and bring back the spheres they're guarding?
That's it in a nutshell, yeah. We're only three short, mind. And we know exactly where they are. There's one up Amberway, in that ruin that they call Lost Plume, and another in the Silent South, over in Dalmechia. Last one is in the ruins of Advent, which is in the Empire.
All right then. Wish me luck.
Will do. I'll be keeping all my fingers and toes crossed.
I'm gonna double check the hunt board real quick, and then we're gonna dip out. Well, there's no marker, so I'm guessing no. Alright. Search Lost Plume, Advent, and Silent Soul. Okay.
Let's go. Run like the wind.
Okay, so just straight. Sorry, my man on a mission. No, it's not.
Sounds good, Lee.
Advent.
Just two more to find.
Silent Soul. Kindling the Flame 2. Blacksmith Blues. Here's Silent Cell. That's convenient, it's like right here.
Be safe. To go.
Might as well take care of this one since we're in the area. We won't be able to craft it yet, but we get the recipe.
So Dravosht is still standing, for now at least.
Would you like to see my wares? Thank you. Here you are.
What's over there?
Clive, you're here.
And the Akashic?
Mostly off to the north still. But I spoke to Doris's scouts and it turns out things are worse than I thought. There's swarms of them out there. Told old Snotty to be ready to seal the north gate. That should buy us some time if we need it. Enough for the villagers to barricade themselves inside their homes at least.
Well done.
Welcome back, Sid. I'd never have guessed, you know. Not if August hadn't let slip. Who'd have thought that the savior of Dravosht would turn out to be the realm's most infamous outlaw? Keen to help us out again?
I am.
Thought you could sneak off without me, did you?
Blackthorn.
Oh, what are you doing here?
One of the scouts couldn't keep his voice down. Unlike my best mate who didn't think I deserved to know. Zoldan, how long's it been? Long enough for us two to turn into a pair of old codgers, I see.
Then your idea of an apology. Prick.
Don't listen to him. You only did what you thought was best. For the village and that.
I did, yeah. But that ain't the whole of it. Vulcan, our master, didn't leave the chieftain to the two of us. He left it to me. The best blacksmith in Dravosht, barring himself, of course. Bloody stupid tradition, in my opinion. If someone's got talent, you should let them practice their craft, not ask them to settle petty feuds and barter for grain. Our master wasted half his life that way. I wasn't about to let that happen to me.
So you're wasting half of mine instead?
You're what Dravosht needed.
Under me and my precious ideals, this place wouldn't have lasted a year. So I left to devote myself to the work and spare you lot the consequences. I may be a selfish prick, but I only did what I felt I had to.
What you had to do was your duty!
Even if it meant we all starved?
Enough. This is no time for bickering. You can finish beating each other up once Dravosht is safe.
Fine. I've said my piece anyway.
Yeah. So have I.
Sorry, Clive. I shouldn't have stuck my nose in. Short enough on time as it is. Still, give us a moment, would you?
Zoltan.
I need to get my head straight before any of them Akashic try to.
Wasn't Drakengard too? I've recognized his voice. Colin McFarlane. No, I guess not, unless he's uncredited. Who voiced him? Gizmore. Jonathan Keeble apparently voiced him. They sound a little relatively similar, but I guess not. I guess I'll do a quick BRB. Looking into it, the Gotterman Dang or whatever it's called. It seems like you get it, or you're able to craft it by the second to last main mission, which is a bit disappointing.
We can't afford to waste any more time.
Right you are. Might be worth having one last word with the scouts, though.
Granted, we're...
Don't want any nasty surprises, do we?
Kind of close to that.
Blackthorn, you and Zoltan might be better off staying inside the...
Akashic on the move.
How close are they?
Within sight of the walls. And there are more coming up from the mines.
What was I saying about nasty surprises?
They'll wash right over us if we stay out in the open. We're pulling back behind the gates.
Good idea. Get yourselves inside, but keep your weapons handy.
Understood.
I'm prepared to fight if I have to.
Well, let's hope you don't. That's our job. Once the scouts are inside, order your men to barricade the gates. No heroic last stands, you hear me? No fighting at all if you can help it.
August's right. I've seen what Akashic Beast can do to armor. The people here are tough and willing, but they ain't equipped to face what's coming.
I'm going out there. Start work on the gate as soon as I've left. I'll give you as much time as I can.
And if they kill you?
You evacuate. But it won't come to that. I promise.
You'd better be right.
Take good care of Dravosht till I get back.
Leave it to me. And... give those things what for, yeah?
Okay. Oh boy, that's a big boy.
All right. Which one of you is first?
I'm gonna try to go for the Shiva trophies. Stop it. Let me freeze you. It's gotta be permafrost, though. There we go. Diamond Dust would charge faster. Torgon, please don't kill enemies.
Help me, boy. To me, boy. Help me, boy. To me, boy.
Maybe if I keep spamming heal, he won't attack anybody.
Help me, boy. To me, boy.
Halfway there. Help me, boy.
To me, boy. To me, boy. To me, boy.
Ow.
I'm hurt, Torgo. To me, boy. To me, boy. I'm hurt, Torgo.
Come on.
I'm hurt, Torgo. Help me, boy. I'm hurt, Torgo.
Almost there. Maybe we already got it. I don't fucking know. Did we already get it? Because there's three enemies, right? Or maybe it's more than that. Earned eight. No. Not earned. How many is it then? How many? Well, I guess it didn't count for some reason. Weird. Well, if it isn't the Midnight Cutie herself, you should check your Discord. I sent you something. Something you missed. Oh no, no, this you don't have to. This isn't a download. This is just a screenshot from Final Fantasy 16 that I sent you. I mean, I also sent you the RAR of your emote, sure, but no, the screenshot you can look at now, and you're probably just gonna be like, AO? Like, I just sent it to you, like, I don't know, 30 minutes ago?
Is that it? Apparently not.
Oh boy, big boy.
You're not getting close.
Oh no, I didn't want to do that. Hope your little vacay is going well with your little your big family to get together. You cute fuck. Was your reaction AO? Like I thought it would be? Yeah, it was an entire cinematic of Clive nude, dude. I was like thinking to myself during it, it's like, oh man, Greedy's gonna be very upset when she realizes she missed this cinematic. So I had to take a screenshot of it. Just for you. It was a very tender scene. It was very well directed. Go to bed, cutie. Thank you for stopping by. You cute fuck. Enjoy your emotes as well. And enjoy the rest of your trip. Mimi.
Question is, did I miss any?
Man alive! You're still in one piece!
I slew as many as I could.
As many as I could, he says. The old bleeding lot, more like it. Well, almost.
Only almost.
Yeah, one or two did try to sneak over the wall. But we got the bastards, don't you worry.
Good. Though you do know, more will come in time.
In time, yeah. But we can think about them later. Let's get you back inside.
Sid! You're even more fearsome than your reputation. Enough to give those Akashic monsters nightmares. I almost felt sorry for the wretched things. But mostly, I felt grateful. Dravost won't forget what you did today.
I'm afraid I've only delayed the inevitable. There's no getting rid of that ether flood. Meaning that any living thing which stumbles into those mines will end up clawing at your walls again.
And that's if the flood don't spread. If it does, well, I hate to say it, but the village's days are numbered.
That may be, but we're staying just the same. With the Aetherflood springing up all over,
It's no less safe than anywhere, and more importantly, it's our home. We'll fortify the gates to the north, and I'll see that they're guarded day and night.
All right. Then we'll give you a hand shoring up those defenses.
As for you, Blackthorn, that's twice you've turned up when Dravosh needed you. So, thanks.
I shouldn't have stayed away so long. And I shouldn't have left without talking it over with you first.
Too bloody right you shouldn't. Though I doubt I'd have listened. I always envied you. How you made everything look so easy when, for me, it was anything but. You leaving gave me the perfect excuse to hate you. And from that day on, I never once stopped to wonder what it would have been like if you'd stayed. But what you said earlier, it was true. You'd have been the death of this place.
Finally, something we can agree on. I hope you see the sense of it eventually. You kept this place alive.
Alive, perhaps. Wealthy, even, but Dravosh isn't what it once was. Our work used to be the pride of Dalmechia. Now, we churn out the same rubbish day after day, because it's easy and turns a profit. It's not about the craft anymore. I wouldn't send my sons to war wearing the shit most of our smiths are making. I've kept working, honing my skills, trying to lead by example, but no one sees the point. The average castle apprentice has as much passion for the craft as our current lot. Come back to us, Blackthorn. Remind Dravosh what a true master blacksmith looks like. I'll even man those bellows of yours if it means we can work at the same forge again.
That's a kind offer. Kinder than I deserve. And I wish I could.
Okay, I'm just gonna make sure I don't use or
there's people who trust their
shall come
and I dare let him down.
In Darksteel. Well, we don't have any Darksteel yet.
That doesn't mean I couldn't visit from time to time. Let's see if we can't rekindle this town's passion for the craft, shall we?
I'd like that.
Just be sure to tell Snotty to let me in the next time I come calling, yeah?
Knowing him, he'd let you in anyway.
We should already have one
Blackthorn.
From Atlas.
The Master Smith
turned unless we accidentally used
back
it.
In my good graces. I never thought I'd see the day.
We'll double check after this is done.
I'd say that went pretty well, wouldn't you?
Even better than I'd hoped.
Sid, I've got something for you.
And this is?
A token of our lasting gratitude. But I'm of a mind to make you a far grander gift. Designs for a certain sword have been passed down from chief to chief for generations.
Now hold on, Zoltan. There's a reason no one's made that blade in centuries. There's not been a craftsman equal to the task. I'll admit your cinders make impressive steel, and I've learned to own an edge Odin will be proud of. But the engravings on that thing are enough to make a jeweler cry. And they're not just for show, either.
Have you forgotten what brought you back to Dravosh in the first place? A certain ring? I knew I'd never surpass you with a hammer and tongs, so I turned my hand to a different kind of metalwork between the two of us. I'd say we're the equal of any master craftsman ever to have graced a forge.
You know what? I think you might be right. Clive, you wouldn't mind if Zoltan came back to the Hideaway, would you?
He's more than welcome. As long as he can keep our secret.
Right. Zoltan, get your tools. We've got a legend to forge.
Oh boy! Advent. The fuck is Advent? No, this is where I came from. Fuck. Fuck! No, it's just showing the same shit. Fuck! All right. Oh, good. I already have two. So I only need one more of those. Good. Good.
Can uncross his toes now.
Okay. So I'm going to put off all the other side quests till later. Till just before end of the game.
Covered in nicks and lumps, the lot of them.
I'm going to nick your lump. You fuck.
Aye, it's a dangerous world out there. You're rubbing me blind, you know. Finished, are you? The stew's off.
Ah,
the man himself. We were just about to make a start on that sword I promised you. It's funny, but none of this would have been possible without your help.
That's funny.
You remember Camille? We'll be using his leather work for the grip. The steel, meanwhile, will be tempered in a fire burning the cinders you charmed out of old Zoltan here. And that whetstone from the Outer Isles? That'll be what gives the blade its edge. And the final flourish will be my talented colleague's engraving.
A team effort led by the greatest blacksmith alive.
Now. Save that talk to the thing's finished, yeah? Right. I'm ready if you are.
To the bellows it is, then.
Okay.
actually did it. The sword to end all swords.
Except for her, there's a better sword.
Ragnarok.
It's quite something.
I trust you'll take good care of it.
Yeah.
Thank you. Both of you.
So, does this make you pair the greatest craftsman alive, then?
This? Nah. This was just following the footsteps of the greats of old. It'll take more than that to earn us our place in history. But we're up for the challenge. Here.
A list of materials.
Zoltan and I got talking on the long road back from Dravosht.
We reckon with those items there, we could craft something even better than the Ragnarok.
Oh my god.
Something worthy of a legendary outlaw like yourself.
Oh my god.
That's a weapon I'd like to see. You leave this list with me.
I was hoping you'd say that.
One legend at a time, eh, lads? Before you start on the next, who fancies raising a cup to Friendship Reforged?
Shut up.
Good idea.
Shut up, you fucking Melvin.
No more drinking to forget my past.
You fucking donkey.
It's about time I had something to celebrate.
Then tap the kegs. Vulcan's boys are on their way.
Bazinga, give me a quick second here. Hey, that was enough to level up, baby. Okay. Wow, that's a steep increase. I'll take it.
What do you want? And? So what do I owe the honor? I never thought me and Zoltan would ever speak again, let alone work together. And if it hadn't been for you, we wouldn't. You've been a good friend of me, Clive. The best. You do what you need to do, Clive.
Oh, don't tell me we run out of papio nuts and all.
Well, let's do this potion thing and then we'll do a BRB and start doing main quest shit.
Expecting you back so soon. So, is it good news or bad?
Good, thankfully. Yeah.
That's brilliant! Thanks a blimmin' million! I'll fit him to the smelter right away! I present to you the Telamon Furnace! Isn't bad, is she?
She's a beauty.
You saved my bacon again, Sid, and I ain't about to let your good deed go unrewarded.
It's fine, really. My bag's flexible enough already.
Oh, don't say that. I'm sure I can make a few improvements to it yet.
You could just buy me a bigger...
How about that clasp? Looks a bit stiff. Reckon you could loosen it up and make some more room? And I reckon I know how. With a new alloy we've been working on. The Telemon furnace was just what we needed to perfect it. It's a metal, see? So it's lovely and strong, but it's also, well, stretchy, if you can believe it.
Stretchy metal. Well, if you insist.
That is the spirit. You'll love it, I promise. So, what do you reckon?
It's actually quite ingenious. Thank you, Owine.
Shh, don't mention it. You earned it. And I wanted to get some practice in using that metal anyway. Reckon we'll have all kinds of uses for it around the hideaway. Can't think of any right now, but that's our job, isn't it? Dreaming up new ways to make life easier around here. Maybe even out there, too. One day, the whole world's gonna know about the inventions you've helped us put together. Yours will be the first of many. You mark my words.
They'll hardly believe their eyes, I'm sure.
Bazinga. All right. Yerby. All right. Let's get the show on the road. Also.
But not nearly as well as you should be. Your cuts and burns may have healed, but your body still bears the burden of every spell cast.
And what would you have had me do? It was no ordinary foe we faced. It was the Warden of Darkness. Yet still, it was not enough. The King could have ended me at any moment, but instead chose to toy with me like a curl does a mouse.
You underestimate yourself.
Oh, it was crystal clear. Only one man established his dominance that day, and that man was Barnabas. I'm sorry, brother. That was ill-spoken. It's just, I have never felt so powerless. And when so many are looking to us for strength, perhaps... perhaps the prince feels the same.
What is this place?
Don't move! It's fresh from the well. Grandmother told me spirits sometimes get lost, and that the lanterns guide them to their proper place. I set one on the river for her when she passed away.
Fiend works from the shadows. Was it you who guided my hand then, Ultima? No, not you. This is my doing, my fault, my sin to bear. And for it, I must atone.
Your hurts are healing nicely. It was my poultices that saw you well.
You make them?
And sell them, or try to. Earns me enough for bread, most days.
Forgive me. I have nothing to...
I know, but I couldn't just leave you lying there. You're going then?
Of course. I'm healed. Thanks to you and your poultices.
Fantasy girl bathwater.
Promise to come back and visit.
Phoenix, it would seem that I owe you my wings.
Perhaps he can find an answer. You will be returning to Walud soon, I gather.
I see no reason to wait.
Then neither do I.
I can think of a few, but I doubt they'll stop you. You will take your medicine.
Of course, Lady Tyre.
Set on leaving already, are you?
Oh, go away!
How long will it take us to get back to Ash?
Dunno, about the same amount of time it took us to get here. Maybe less, if your uncle can find someone trustworthy to patch up the Enterprise. All depends on where we're putting into port, mind.
Yes, it's not as if we can put ashore wherever we choose. We have to assume that the whole of Ash is hostile, and that we'll be attacked on sight.
Then we must find a place they won't think to look. And I have an idea who might know of one.
The Professor! I'll go and tell you, come in!
While you're plotting our course, I'll be in the shelves with your lawsman. I wish to pick his brains about Ultima.
Then I'll talk to Karen about supplies for the journey. They may not be easy to come by in Ash.
Your brother's body won't take much more of this recklessness. You know that, don't you?
I do.
still say it were a compliment. Ah, Clive. I was wondering when you'd arrive. Please tell me you've come to take our young prodigy here off my hands.
I'm not here for Mid. I need information on Ash.
Then why not ask Molly if you can look in one of her ovens? Go on.
As soon as the Enterprise is ready, we'll be setting out for Drake's Spine. And we're going to need a safe place to land.
Preferably one that won't see my ship blown to shit and splinters.
If it were that easy, do you think Walud would have resisted invasion for so long? Very little is known of Ash, and the information we do have is spotty and outdated. We have the good King Barnabas to thank for that. Walud's borders have been closed to outsiders since the day he seized the throne. If there is anywhere safe to land, you won't find it on my map.
Then tell us what we will find. I'm sure you know better than we do.
But no splinters!
All right. If it will get you out of my hair. But interrupt me, and it's over. Understood? Barnabas Tharm. The one they call the Last King. Understand him, and you will understand the kingdom of Walud. Barnabas was only a boy when he arrived from beyond the southern seas, and barely a man before he united the ragged tribes of Ash. And having unleashed them upon the formidable Veldemark, he set his throne upon the ancient kingdom's ruins. The victory sent shockwaves around Valisthea. Tales of Odin's might spreading through every court, parlor, and drinking hole in the realm. Note that this was in the year 843, and that the king still sits upon his throne some 40 years later, quite untouched by time. Walud's recent inaction left many wondering if Odin had lost his appetite for war. And yet here we are. The Einherjar was committed to the fray, a bold declaration of intent. Orcs swarm around Drake's Fang, and throngs of Akashic haunt canvas streets. Though how precisely the havoc they wreak serves Walud remains unclear. Regardless, if the order to attack truly came from King Barnabas, then one thing is certain. Walud has achieved the impossible, and made bedfellows of beastmen and the Aether-addled alike. All of which is a roundabout way of saying that you will be in unknown territory when you set foot on Ash. Much of the continent has already been lost to the Blight, and what few ports remain will be fiercely guarded. And that is to say naught of its natural defenses. Offshore currents will cast an ill-equipped ship out to sea one moment, and dash it against the rocks the next. But then the Enterprise is anything but ill-equipped, and Mid has made land there before. Now, if only there were someone with an intimate knowledge of the Shadow Coast, and where a daring gentleman might put ashore. You see, Clive, you had the answer all along.
Do you think you can get us back to that beach, Mid?
Picked you up from it, didn't I? Not that it were easy. The currents were a right bastard. But then, if it wasn't hard, it wouldn't be worth doing, would it?
Well said. Thank you, Lady Vivian.
If a few morsels of common knowledge and a sprinkling of tavern talk are worthy of your thanks, I wonder what genuine intelligence might earn me.
Probably more visits. Mid, I need everyone in the ale hall now. I'll fetch Joshua from the shelves.
Aye, aye, Captain.
You must listen to this. Rosman, tell him.
Do you recall when we spoke before on the divinity of Ultima? Well, it inspired me to delve deeper into the subject. And what I discovered appears to agree with the findings of His Grace.
You will recall that my quest to uncover Ultima's origins began with the mural at Phoenix Gate. But while I've always known it to be important, its secrets have heretofore eluded me. Now, however, I believe I know where to find the more complete example, one that will reveal all we seek.
Master Clive, have you ever in your travels chanced to hear of the Circle of Malleus? I would think not, if you have. But there was once a time when the faith flourished, the oldest known religion in the Twins, and though its popularity eventually waned on Storm, hints of its dogma remain embedded in more modern faiths such as the Crystalline Orthodox.
Wait, you said it waned on Storm. What of Ash?
Religious monuments are often torn down or repurposed when new faiths rise to prominence. But if no new faith arose, then perhaps the ancient temples might still stand. And so, you see now why I must accompany you to Walud.
It would appear the past still has much to teach us. Though in this case, it would not have been possible without the musings of Moss. To think that you carried a copy of my old mentor's chronicles all along. I am relieved to discover it in good hands.
I shall guard it with my life.
Joshua, if you're finished here, join me in the Ale Hall. I need to speak to everyone before we leave.
Right away.
You admitted I can ride the Enterprise next.
My apologies.
By now you've all heard where we're going and why. So I won't bother you with the boring details, only the important ones. If we attempt to approach Stone here by sea, there's a good chance we'll be sighted and fall prey to the capital's artillery. So instead, we'll disembark on the southwest coast and make for Drake's Spine on foot. I say we, but it's highly likely the entirety of Ash is under the rule of Ultima. A large party would only attract unwanted attention, as well as slow our march and require supplies which may be difficult to obtain. Only Joshua and I will be going. And a scout. Preferably a good one. Gav, do you know of any?
You bet your ass I do. Might still borrow some of Lady Vivian's maps, though. Just in case, like.
Once you've dropped us off at the Shadow Coast, you need to retreat into neutral waters, fly merchant colors, and stay inconspicuous. If you sense any danger at all, you leave us behind and return to Storm.
Inconspicuous is my middle name. But like hell am I leaving anyone behind. The ship ain't going nowhere till your scurvy mugs are smiling on deck.
Jill, the Enterprise will appear a tempting target for Royalists and Pirates alike. You're to stop anyone boarding.
Don't worry. I'll keep the ship and her crew safe. You'll be needing passage home, after all.
But very well.
If there are no questions, I'll see you all at the docks.
Let me know when you're leaving. I want a word before you go.
Of course.
Covered in nicks and lumps, the lot of them.
Is something wrong?
Not at all. Honestly. Can't a man wish his friend farewell?
Just wanted to let you know that I'll keep things in order while you're off saving the world.
I'll hold you to that.
Oh boy.
Reckon it'll be a long walk to the capital if we follow the cliffs. I'll scout ahead. See if I can't find us an inland route.
Clive. There's something I've been meaning to ask. You took her icon, didn't you?
Yes, I did. She understood.
Oh, she understood. Understood that you decided to save the world all on your own, and that you'd die without her power. How dare you make her choose? You knew damn well she'd never refuse you. But I will. You can't keep pushing us away, Clive. The world is ours to save, not yours.
I used my gift because I thought it was the right thing to do.
And you truly believe this will save you, will save us all?
I do.
Then so be it. Just don't forget, you're not alone.
I think I found us a trail. Did I miss something?
Only that Joshua didn't.
I don't get it.
Oh boy.
Always wanted to visit Ash.
We're in Waluda territory now. Don't expect a warm welcome.
Oh, I don't know, Clive. That castle over there looks inviting enough.
Shall we sample its inhabitants' hospitality?
Said about warm welcomes, Gav.
Oh, this place is as dead as Grieger's ghost. I knew I smelled something.
Not really, no.
Let's hope the villagers made it out in time.
Yeah.
Well, keep it in mind.
All over again. Where the hell are the royalists?
Seems you were right about that welcome after all, Clive. Peace delegation. We should send a warning to the others.
No. My uncle will have an eye on the coast. I trust he'll find a way to entertain any uninvited guests. Our mark is Drake's spine, and there's a lot of road between us and it. We press on to Stonehere.
Aye. You never know. It might not be an Estus Slaverin monsters.
Clive, you must go on ahead without me.
What?
This stronghold is as old as Phoenix Gate, perhaps older. It may yet hide Ultima's remaining secrets, and if we are to best him, they must be unearthed.
All right. Stay out of trouble.
I always do. Mostly.
You sure about this?
About leaving my brother on his own. Of course. Mostly.
Lady Vivian's map is so old, it's hard to tell which way is up. But if I'm right, we're not far from a village called Aestla.
Then we make our way there, resupply, and wait for Joshua. I needed that.
Ugh, this place reeks like a marble's asshole. Though I'm guessing it's not the smell that'll kill us.
I'm just running past you fuckers. None of y'all look interesting.
No mistakes.
I want to try to do two more main quests before we raid out for the night. So this one and the next one. Piece of shit! You hit my bird, now you have to die. Oh boy.
Bahamut's breath. Don't look down, Torgal. That must be Aestla.
You deserve a rest.
What do you think, Clive?
Then we're too late.
Damn it. They're all turned. There's nothing we can do.
I would excuse me. Nothing.
No quarter, Gav!
No quarter!
Later,
Gav.
Oh. Get fucked.
Gav! Don't tell me there's more of the bastards. Oh, fuck.
Oh, goody.
Have you come to watch, Odin?
Bound for Stonehenge. Good. My master awaits you in the capital, though I cannot allow you to attend him in your present state.
And how are you going to stop us?
Why, with this!
What the fuck?
What did you do?
If the vessel would see the path opened, it has but to ask. I shall see that my master's prize is made presentable.
Shit! No!
Clive? Would you mind telling me what the fuck just happened? Oh, you've
got to be. How are we supposed to get through that?
We seek an audience with the king. If his majesty wants me to come and ask him, then that is exactly what I'll do.
Before you go practicing your petition, we don't even know where the fucker went. How about we cool our heads and think this through, eh?
All right.
Maybe there's something here we can use.
Oh boy. I'm starting to get sleepy though. Despite taking a fat nap.
I thought we got them all.
So did I.
Turned, all right?
Who?
Forgive me for asking, but what went on here?
It all started when the skies changed. The elders said it was the Ark. One by one, people went mad. Minds taken by the ether. Till only I remained. By then, I was too far alone to run. And then the knights came. And I didn't know what to do.
And this, okay. Is
just a story. Something our grandparents told us when we misbehaved. About how the heavens would grow dark before the land took her last breath.
The end of the world. You said the others went mad. But where did they go?
They all left, drawn east to the tower, to Reverie, the elders, the healer, the blacksmith, my husband.
Thinking he did this.
Of course. Who else could it be? You were in Canva. You saw what he did to the people.
But then what about her? How come her nut hasn't cracked?
baby, perhaps? Could be protecting her from the ether. I can't think of any other explanation.
You mean... it's a bearer?
It won't matter what it is once Ultima's magic takes hold. Time's running out.
This tower... that's where we'll find the king.
I knew it. It's the same as Phoenix Gate. Which means at the end of these stairs should be... The mural is complete. Ultima and his vessel, Ifrit. Garuda, Ramu, Shiva, Titan, Bahamut, Odin. Even Leviathan the Lost is here. But where is the Phoenix? By the Founder.
Bailey Jameson, thank you for the raid.
Isn't it?
How was your stream?
So that's how it's gonna be then.
I'm not asking, Gav. I need you to stay with Edda.
What?
I must do this alone. If I don't return, you're to find Joshua and make for the Enterprise. Understood?
Aye. Just don't you go dying on me. Sid's name suits your miserable mug better than mine.
No, I understand completely. Thank you so much for the raid. Have a good night.
Don't worry. I haven't finished with it yet.
Hopefully your stream went well. Didn't realize my mic was muted. Apologies.
Barnabas is controlling the Akashic. Then wherever he goes, they'll follow. And so will I.
Buckle, y'all. Because I'm pretty sure I can't warp out of here. So I want to complete this quest and then maybe the next. I was hoping that this quest would be done sooner. Before I head to sleep.
This is it, boy.
Hey, we can travel. Alright. Use this time to get in one last BRB, or possibly one last, we'll see. Anyways, I'll BRB. Alright, let's get back to it.
I've come for you, Barnabas. Stay close, Torgal.
Oh boy. Ooh. Cool, we are on the quest that I wanted to end on.
The tower.
All right, come to life.
I needed that. If I were Barnabas, where would I be? At the top. So I could look down on the world.
That was a little bullshitty. Oh, we got a big boy.
Well, that's new. Though I expect him to feel like all the rest.
Get fucked.
What was that thing? Hopefully there aren't any more.
Fuck. And how much was it? 8? 6. Wonder if I missed anything. Cause this is feeling like it's heading to Barnabas. Could be wrong. Oh, never mind. The big orb. Oh, Jesus.
Thank you.
Fuck you.
Almost there. He's here. I can feel him.
The blade must ever feed if her edge is to remain keen.
Watcha.
What care you for these worthless creatures? They are nothing. Weak from the moment of their conception, ever longing for power not theirs to command, they turn unfailingly upon themselves. Like sheep, they roam in filthy flocks, eager to trample those few gifted a fleece of gold. Or that they might feel contentment with their pitiful existence. Prejudice and persecution, severance and strife, every earthly wrong springs from the malice in men's hearts. Malice born of the pain and suffering that is free will. Its corruption is gnawed at your being from the very moment of your birth.
You're wrong. It is no corruption.
It is who I am. Every choice I make, right or wrong, gives me reason to carry on. And carry on I shall. Not as a puppet, but as a man. Which are you?
There was a time I too thought those the only choices.
What?
Long ago, God granted man the gift of magic. And with that gift did he build great civilizations. Yet over time, man lost sight of the gift's true meaning, stepping from the path of shared prosperity to one of avarice. He abandoned his creator for sword and flame, and through his folly, beckoned the blight. Yet, there were those few who refused to turn their eyes from the heavens, and they prayed to God that he might lead them back to righteousness. And the Lord, he did answer. Before the worthy shall the gates of paradise open. And so did I spread my arms to the ether and cast my soul upon its gentle waters. I gave myself unto him. The Lord charged me thus. If your kind are to find salvation, they must be made to serve. You see, paradise lies but a single step away. Could we only take it? Could we only leave our transgressions behind? For none save the pure of heart and mind may set foot in the new world. I will save us. But it all begins and ends with you. You are the key, Mythos. And with this humble offering, shall I prove my faith once more.
So you forsook your kingdom. You forsook yourself to serve. Tell me, how is that living? You seek to provide is not salvation. It's anything but. Life is about always having a choice. Take that away, and we might as well be dead.
Very well. Come then. Show us the strength of your will.
Oh boy.
It's not the strength of my will that should worry you, but the weakness of yours.
No!
old, yet still you fight like a man.
You will obey me.
You to serve as his vessel, and you cling to this foolish notion of hope when there is none. Disappointing.
you turned your back on the truth, Barnabas. We are not as weak as your God believes.
Good Torgal. I was getting worried that Torgal might bite the bullet there.
Damn it.
Made a weapon of your weakness? My apologies. You are not the fool I took you for. That's so it ends. Tell me you are tired, Mythos! Your stubborn defiance has stirred my long-becalmed heart, filling it with a joy that I have not known for generations! I had thought the tantalizing kiss of self-indulgence a dream forever out of reach! And now that its sweet ruin courses through my veins, I shall not be quick to relinquish it. Show me your work, Mythos, that I might revel in it!
Yeah!
engagement of lesser rivals. But no more! Salvation is come! Rejoice as our souls are granted peace unending!
How do you know this day will come? What proof have you?
I knew this. Your mere existence is proof of the Lord's grand design. I'll never serve your God!
fucking finally get fucked.
Well, the day is at an end.
And we both know the truth. It is I who stand victorious. My will that prevailed.
Your will? No. It was his.
Clive Rossfield.
Yeah, fuck you, Barnabas.
My own.
You relinquish nothing. What was it, if not will, that made you strive for a new world? Strive to win your master's approval. Shown a fantasy, and you chose to believe it. But you were wrong. There is no world but the one we live in. And that world is worth saving, even if it means killing a god.
I promised that I would make you presentable, did I not? We shall fulfill our destinies, just as the Lord's Mother Crystals have fulfilled theirs. Come, Clive Rossfield. Take what is rightfully yours. Become one with God.
No.
Long lost salvation. I'm coming home, Mother.
Tell me, how does it feel?
Show yourself! Face me!
How does it feel to consume your rival's strength? To gorge yourself on their being? To edge step by trembling step ever closer to the divine? With or without a will, you are still but a vessel. Our vessel. Behold, how your body shudders in anticipation of its fate.
Oh. It's not yours yet.
No. Come then, O wayward child. We shall await you upon the back of the first worm. There, all shall end and begin again.
Indeed. The enemy numbers 200,000 or more counting yours.
There are simply not enough soldiers garrisoned in the capital to repel an army of that size.
Then one of the central keep,
held by a contingent of soldiers and bearers from the surrounding boroughs. They are the sole reason it still stands. And all it took was an army on their doorstep to bring them together.
The prospect of death does put things into perspective.
Perspective. Perhaps it's what we've lacked all along.
He fights for a world in which he shouldn't have to live and die.
us all a chance of a better tomorrow.
Be that as it may, a handful of men cannot stand against a kingdom.
Then mayhap they are the wrong men.
Well, I'll be damned.
Our numbers are few, but I shall rally as many of my dragoons as I'm able. You, apprise the Lord Strategist of the state of the city's defenses.
Yes, Your Radiance.
And you would fight alongside us?
I owe the Phoenix a debt.
Does this vouch for my nephews?
Aye, but I still have my doubts about you.
Which we can discuss later.
Indeed.
You said you had men garrisoned in the keep. Captain, do you know how many yet remain?
Allow me to confirm. Commander?
Whatever their number, Randalar will be needing
them
all.
Gather the bodies and build a pyre in the courtyard. Quickly.
Terence.
My lord.
You will find a girl there.
A girl? We are in the middle of a war.
I owe her my life, and I always pay my debts. You are to see that she is provided for.
Dion, I cannot leave.
But you shall. If I am ever to be worthy of the forgiveness of our people, then I must earn it. And I must earn it by my hand, and my hand alone. Know that I do not ask this lightly.
And know that I will do it.
Farewell, Terence.
Clive, thank fuck. You all right?
I am. But I'm a damn sight better for seeing you, Joshua.
And Barnabas.
The king is dead.
They are, but so is their killer. He can't hurt anyone anymore. You're safe.
to talk.
I'm sorry, Clive. You know I want nothing more than to go with you.
I do. But I'm glad you're heading back to the Enterprise nonetheless. And not just for Edda's sake. Our people need to know what happened here.
You can count on me.
As can she, I hope.
Thank you for the follow, Thanatos.
Thank you, my lord.
Do you think that was wise?
Wiser than leaving a woman with child alone in the Deadlands. They'll be safer at the hideaway. For now, at least. This land is overrun with Akashic. The king himself was long turned, albeit by choice. All to serve Ultima in his damnable quest to forge the perfect vessel.
The chaos Barnabas wreaked upon nation after nation. How many were killed for this?
He didn't consider it killing. Or a mercy of sorts. A way to end their suffering. He truly wanted to save mankind, and ultimately use that.
As he uses us.
But why us? What are we?
What are we? We are dominance. That is our fate. But that doesn't mean we have to accept it, which is why we fight. For the right to deny it. Is that not so?
It is. For our sins. Barnabas said something else. That the Mother Crystals were Ultimas.
Ultimas? Are you certain?
We know that the Mother Crystals have been leading the land of Aether. And we also know that it's this which hastens the spread of the Blight. But what I cannot fathom is what Ultima stands to gain from that. What did you find at the Stronghold?
The truth about Ultima's prize. For so long, I believed it to be you, and you alone. Yet, it is not merely a freed that he desires, but a freed and Phoenix both, that which we became in the skies over Twinside. Only when the twin flames are joined, shall his vessel be complete. Quite why he needs a vessel is another question. Unless there is something he cannot achieve without one. Something his immaterial form precludes. Something requiring an unthinkable amount of ether and a body resilient enough to channel it. If I did not know better, brother, I would think that he meant to cast a spell. A spell 1,000 years in the making. A spell to end all spells.
And he cannot do it without us, nor without the Mother Crystals. But if we destroy them all, we will stop not only the Blight, but Ultima as well. We stick to the plan then, only this time
we face him together.
Well, it's a long walk to Stonehere. Let's not keep Ultima waiting.
Aye. Alright. Big question is am I locked in this area? Or can I teleport? I can teleport. Beautiful. Good. Okay.
When Barnabas fell.
Oh, stop talking! I want to go to bed!
His magic died with him. The road to stone here is barred to us no longer.
We're done? Alright, we're done. Let me give this a good old Saverino. I don't know when we'll be back with FF16. We'll get to it soon. Ish. I do know that we're getting very close to the end of the game, though, so that's nice. Anyways, Thanatos, thank you so much for the follow, and, Bailey Jameson, thank you for the raid, and Tori, thank you for the resub. I will be back tomorrow with that fucking Pokemon Scarlet DLC. I'm gonna send y'all over to, Ilfinity, who's doing a, subathon for his, 3-year Twitch channel anniversary. Y'all take care of yourselves, stay safe, be excellent to each other, and I'll catch you all on the next stream. Bye-bye. Hey, Jeffy.